Within the legacy of America's ongoing history in Iraq, one story remains to be told. The story of perhaps the greatest benefactors of the Second Gulf War, the Kurds of northern Iraq.
The Kurds are the indigenous people of the Mesopotamia.
The problem with Kurdistan in Iraq, of course, is that in effect it's what the Americans especially left behind.
You really don't ever leave Iraq behind.
Well, Kurdistan is the other Iraq. That's the Iraq that we wanted to build.
What the Kurdish people have achieved is extraordinary.
I have equal rights here. I can express my religious views however way I like.
When I left Kurdistan in 88, I never thought I would come back and we would have this.
Iraqi Kurdistan is an island of stability, a partner in the fight against ISIS.
The Kurds are the most pro-American element, perhaps in the entire region.
The problem is the United States hasn't really asked for a date with the Kurds.
The value of Kurdistan could be the only value we get out of the lives we lost here fighting the war.
Nobody has suffered from the rule of Saddam Hussein as the Kurds suffered.
Even though Saddam Hussein is gone, his shadow is still looming over Iraq. Saddam Hussein ensured that after he is gone, the Iraqis will be fighting each other.
Iraq is breaking apart, and that's good.
The idea of a three-way Iraq is not only simplistic, it's dangerous.
There would be enormous sectarian cleansing.
Was it ever really together?
That's a very good question.
It's already partitioned. We're just not accepting that.
We're fighting ISIS on behalf of the whole world.
The Kurds are not the type that go on their knees.
Iraq lived all its life under emergency law. Why?
80 years of Arab governing, enough. We would like to be free.
That will be unacceptable by us.
The war in Iraq has not finished yet.
The Kurds are not victims anymore. This will be very bloody.